Okay, guys, I have a general plan for this episode. I really want to explore Ark, like the whole of Ark, so my plan, as of now, which may change, hopefully not, is to, well, explore Ark and just see what it has to hold for us, really, like just the wonders and the beauty that it is, because I feel like I've just sort of run through it and not really... See, that guy was holding a broom. And it magically disappeared up his butt.
You're a foreigner, aren't you? I wish I'd have crossed the Red Sea once, or seen Kira, the Grand Bazaar. Ah, well.
You're not too old to do it, buddy. You can still do it. You got the pennies. Anyway, so yeah, I want to just explore the areas and see what it has to offer. That's all this episode is going to entail, really, so feel free to give this one a skip.
But
seriously, don't. I need the views.
Lick your lips in untamed desire as the ambrosial smells of our unrivaled fresh and tasty.
I've already listened to her. So what do we have in Ark anyway? What do we have? We've got the current location. That's always good. The foreign quarter, the military barracks, the marketplace, the south quarter. Noble's quarters, we haven't even checked that too well. And the Sun Temple, yeah, I suppose we can go check out the Sun Temple as well. I feel like this place we've sort of seen what it has to offer a fair bit. I'm not too fussed about this area, and that is just gorgeous. Oh, of course I have to take a screenshot of that. I love their attention to detail, their artwork is just amazing. Hi.
Huh? Can I help you?
Any news?
What? You mean apart from frenzied animals, hordes of living dead lurking through the wilderness and this whole red madness thing? No, none. Just be careful when you're outside the walls.
Just be careful when you're outside the walls. That's me. Where's this go to? Marketplace. That should take us where we need to go. Alright, we've seen a fair bit of the marketplace, actually, so once again, not terribly fussed about this area. There's a lot of people just shouting things at me, for sure. The herald is gone, though.
You just wait and see, fucking sissy.
The light fades away at the end of the day. Ta-dum-dum.
What the hell is your problem, Cook?
A foreigner, huh? What a surprise.
Why does a cook have an axe? That's what I want to know. Could have talked to that Wolfgang guy, but I think it was a quest, actually, that guy. Gotten... There we go. That's the button there. So I suppose the Undercity would be a good stop to take. Where does this go to? This might be the Noble's Quarter. Yeah, let's go there. I wonder if that cherries man is still
Walk
here.
Blessed.
Walk blessed to you too. Oh man. I'm assuming that's where the Sun Temple is. Oh, hi.
A penny, my sir. Thank you. That's really generous. May his light guide you.
I'm surprised I had a penny to give. I'm pretty sure I definitely don't have two pennies to give, at least. I think
yes.
I leads to the barracks. So we want to go... Hello?
Hey, wait a minute, you... Never mind.
What is it?
Oh, you're an Eterna, aren't you? Your ears...
Why do you ask?
I mean no offense, really, I'm just... Well...
My mother!
On Nehrim? But that must have been horrible. I heard that Eterna don't have any rights in Nehrim and are treated like animals. Huh. You know, once this chaos in the world is over, I want to go travel myself. Who knows? Maybe a captain will hire me as a deckhand. Anyway...
Oh, blessed. She had the same dialogue as the previous person.
Oh,
the cherries man's back! Still talking the same stuff? Yep.
Oh, yes.
Oh, you're not from around here, are you? I know that accent.
scent?
I didn't even talk to you. Go away. Don't judge me.
Mmm. Oh, yummy. Tastes like cherries.
Prince Sandrio. What? Dark veils between fire and ice. Loneliness of the elder man.
What the? I beg your pardon?
In the fangs of violence, my heart laughs. So hot, yet so cold. Oh no. Such woe. Crutch. Ahoo!
But by the righteous path, this is incredible. I've never heard anything like this before. Tell me, my friend, where did you learn this? Who taught you poetry?
None. I'm an autodidact.
Blazes, you're self-taught. Malphus truly did bless you with talent. Tell me, may I interpret your poem? It's just I have to.
Be my guest.
Well then, I hope this is not too much of a leap, but does your first line, the one with the dancing elder between fire and ice, deal with the socio-sexual isolation of old people in feudal societies? I may be wrong, but that was the first thought that came to my head.
That was what I meant indeed. By Malphus. And yeah, I was thinking the metaphor was too risky.
No, not at all. I was particularly moved by how you used onomatopoeia in line 4 and 6. Do these brutal noises at the end of each verse symbolize the hedonistic, violent way of life among the common people who have absolutely no regard for the lonely man?
Exactly. Wow. What about the second poem?
Phew. Well, that's a tough one. To me, it sounds like the inner voice of a murderer. Yes, exactly. He celebrates his bloodthirsty way of life. In the fangs of violence, my heart laughs. And then, suddenly, justice ends him, which is once again conveyed through those guttural noises. And I have to say, how you use the uneven number of verses as a metaphor for the discord that results from such a lifestyle is nothing short of brilliant. If that's what you meant by it, of course. You did, didn't you?
Shit, Roy, we're in too deep. I don't know what a pony is. We gotta get out of here. Why, yes. You're incredible. I thought no one would ever understand.
Well, you know what? They wouldn't. The common people, they don't even understand when I tell them I'm a poet. Poet, they ask? What kind of profession is that? So now I simply tell them I'm an innkeep. That is something they are able to grasp with their limited intellect. Easy answers. That's what people long for. But you know what? I would rather die hungry than become one of those soulless potboiler artists who make a fortune off their stupid stories. Like Jornus Schmeid does. Do you know him? Mundane rubbish. That's all he writes. But you'll find it on every bookshelf. It's a disgrace. Pure and simple.
Why are Schmeid's stories so bad?
What? What kind of question is that? How can something that so many people like not be rubbish?
You mean anything that's successful has to be trite?
Of course. Not everyone has been blessed with an artist's intellect, you know. There are two kinds of writers. Small rhymes who give the common people fodder that helps them feel smart, and true artists who want more from life. those who create, with no greed for gold and fame, bound solely by the calling of the muse.
I'm not sure I agree here.
Well, then you're certainly more of a simpleton than I thought you were. Hard to believe the gods would waste so much poetic talent on you. I suppose it would be better for the both of us if this conversation ends here and now. In the Shackles of Lust, presented by the poet. Huh?
What the blazes are you doing?
If you have to ask that, you'd better be on your way, my friend. In the Shackles of Lust.
I'm curious as to what he would say if I accepted his. No. If I had to agree with him, because. Well, I don't agree with him, but I'm curious to see what happens if we do agree with him. How's it going? Yeah, I'm way too curious about that. I guess you're right.
Of course I am. I wish it weren't true, but it is. If only there were more people like us. Hymn of the Desert King.
Alright, so yeah, either way, the end of the thing gives you experience. That's cool. That was very interesting. Thanks for safety, Jess.
Orpheus, my sir, please. The Lord will redeem you for your kindness.
Darling, I got 34 pennies, I can't help you. Guardian? Are you my guardian? Gonna just guard my booty? I'm Kim. What's happened up there? Top right hand corner, what the heck is that? I don't know. There's an estate there which I could break into, which I have no reason to break into just yet. Although I would like to break into it sometime. Hey.
Yes?
Hang on, I'm just gonna reload to see if that fixes whatever the hell's happening up there. Nope, it's still there.
Yes?
I'm guessing it's Sky UI messing up. If I was to do this. And wait a bit, would that fix it when it pops up on the screen? Anywho. We can still explore and see what's happening in the Noble Quarter. Actually, it's not as big as I thought it was going to be. Yeah, that's the Noble's Quarter, really. But I suppose that's what you expect, huh? We could go Yara's house. Aristocrats and houses and beggars.
Luck blessed.
Your apprentice, Avira.
You're an Eterna, aren't you? Your ears, they look different.
Right, she's just gonna ask me the same question again. Premium wares from Garbuff. We'll come back to you, Garbuff. I just want to explore the rest of the place. This is the side alley, okay. And down here. Nope, that thing isn't. There's a note. Interested in this house? Then request an audience with Cyril and friends. Hello. Hello there. Gotcha. And what's in the water? A duck. Don't mind me, fellow patrons and such. I'm just getting myself stuck in things. Yeah, I think before we go into... Is it down this way? Is Premier Wares where? I don't remember now. Nope. It's down here. I need to fix that, whatever the hell that is. That's up in the top right hand corner. That's bugging me too much. Okay, good. Fixed. Good.
Who are you?
I am a traveler.
Wow, that's nice armor you're wearing there.
Thanks. It's custom made. I'm currently weak to magic, but thanks.
Men, that's just how they are.
Oh, she's pissed off at you, buddy. I can't. Can you get closer, please? I can't. Just a little bit closer.
I'm closing now. Come back tomorrow.
No.
Now look at that. A new face. How can Gaborga Boff serve you today? A Pyrrhean dagger, mayhaps? No? How about an ancient claymore for the steps of Ereziel?
What is it you're selling here?
Wait. Say that again.
What is it you're selling here?
Oh, by the name of the sun! You're Nehrimaze, aren't you? And even better, you're from Ostian. Oh, by the now deceased seven gods, what brings you here? To Enderal, I mean.
Long story. I take it you're from Ostian, too?
Indeed, I am. And before you ask, I fled, just as you probably did. Even though the artist inside of me loves the chaos, the family man doesn't. At least not enough that he would risk the life of his family. And well, now here I am. By the face of time, what a dull place this is. The people here, this endless rambling about the path and Malthus. I would have never thought the Order could actually succeed in keeping the truth about the Lightborn's death from the people so long. But in a place like this, that problem pretty much solves itself, it seems. The people here are so obstinate, I was surprised to find out they do not still pray to a Satyron.
Suppose I can't acknowledge him. You're an artist, you say?
Oh yes, that I am. Painter of the black powder, the fiery moments, one could say. In Nehrim, I could make a living from that. But in this country, my art is not exactly acknowledged.
He's not that... I saw that name and I thought it looked familiar. He's not the Gabor, well, he's not the guy who I think is Gabor from Nehrim who made all that sort of explosive firework stuff that we used to blow up a temple. I forget what it was for the Order, the other Order. In the South Realm, I think they were? Pretty sure they're South. Wish I had a map of Nehrim right now to look at to refer to that, but he's not that guy. He is a bit cuckoo. He didn't have a family. Well, then again, maybe he made a family here. So you sell artifacts. How the heck do you find them? You don't look like much of a crypt crawler to me.
Oh, my friend. If I were to tell you this, what reason would you have for my services? Secret of the trade.
I see. Show me what you have in stock.
Certainly. Just take your time.
He has books. Account of the Unknown Traveler, Volume 2. We've seen that a few times. A lot of books, right? Blueprints, okay. Blueprints for an Arcane Enchanter. An archery target. Don't know why I'd want an archery target in our home. Ooh, a deer skull. Pretty sure you got a deer skull. No, we just got a normal. No, we do have a deer skull. I was gonna say we had a normal skull, and if we did, I'll just be spending all my money on those. Thank the gods I don't have that, huh? But a deer skull's the next best thing. So you got paintings, other things, yep. So you don't have anything else, right? Talked about daggers and such, but I don't see them. Rattled robe, magic regens 10% faster. Yeah, you literally have diddly, don't you? Well, you buy and sell a whole bunch of random things, so take these off my hands. How much gold do you have? You got 2k. You'll be fine. I should probably sell that one because I've already got one which I stole, but then it's a stolen item, so I prefer to sell the stolen one as opposed to that. Block 7% more damage. Goodbye. It wasn't a set item, was it? That would be silly. No, it's not. I think it says there, it says said item in the actual description itself, so that's alright. Claymore flames? Well, it's a two-handed weapon, we don't need that at all. And he said he had a claymore himself, so have another one. Ambush, we don't ambush people. Okay, we got a woodcutter's axe and a pickaxe, that's all we need. Got a lot of potions we could probably sell off. Eight of these, but that's pretty decent sausages. For those who actually missed that video and probably might miss this one as well, we read the Myths and Legends of the Ash Widow, so we got that quest now, which I will probably do next after tanning in my bounty and all that. Oh yeah, still got some iron ore and whatnot. We need those nails like no tomorrow. Do you have nails, buddy? One thing I didn't look for, because nails we need. Actually, we don't really need nails anymore. We've got some money. Oh. Oh my god. What time is it? 2:37 PM! The frick are you talking about closing early? Get out of town. You don't close a shop at 2:37 PM unless you're in a country which condones something like doing that. I'm not going to read that because that's going to just probably excite him. I think I can use this though. Let's see what we can do. Nope. 420. Blaze it up. 10 salt though. 540. 5. 420 for 9. Okay. 600 for 6. 420 again for 7. Let's do the rest of venison. Alright. Rabbit's foot is just amazing. Alright, we've got enough freaking rabbit's foot to go for a long, long time. Well, Gabor. I'm surprised. Steal the dresser. No, I can steal from the dresser. He's done well for himself.
Hey, you're an adventurer, aren't you? I bet you've got a lot of stories to tell.
Who are you?
Lord Pi. At least you don't tell me I talk funny. Arkdal's estate. Guys,
yeah, that should be it.
Yoda's house? So these are just houses, they're not actual shops per se. Suppose I should dump my crafting items in here. Whilst I remember that they do exist. Little pie. Ooh, hold on to the blueprints, I suppose. Because I don't feel like taking them out every time I need to do crafting. I'd love to get like a crafting chest of some sort. Actually, just a chest in general, that'd be great to get. Although I can just create like other things, like shells and whatnot. Okay, good. So, yeah, I suppose we've explored the Noble's Quarter properly. Oh, except for here. But that's just a tavern, essentially.
Advance the fleet! Always forward! Always forward! Forward for the glory and honor!
I'm glad he has different things to say rather than just cherries all the time. The same play. Oh, the library.
May his light guide you.
Walk blessed.
Alright, let's go to the library.
Malthus's blessing, dear sir. Might I interest you in a ware from my most exquisite assortment?
Show me what you have.
I am certain you will find something.
Seriously?
May his light guide you. Come back. I am certain you... Malthus's blessing, dear sir. Might I interest you in a ware from my most exquisite assortment?
This guy has a library. And he's only selling 3 books. And I saw the Myths and Legends of the Blind Mana, but I'm a bit scared to read books that might be stealing. What's that one? Oh, God.
Malthus's blessing, dear sir. Might I interest
the
you
hell's that?
Anywhere from my most exquisite assortment?
Yeah. We found a strange zone. Let's see if we can accent it. There it is. We found it. Something right there.
Times, these are hard times.
You're out there, Sunshine?
Malthus's blessing, dear sir.
Oh, gods. No, I suppose there's the library. I didn't really look at it too much. But there wasn't much to see, so. Light as the night. I think this will probably take me up to the temple, won't it? Probably. Well, this might not actually take us to the Sun Temple. It's just a guess, it's another route up there. Maybe that's not the Sun Temple itself, maybe that's something completely different to another. Because I still haven't come across the Ark Palace yet, which I assume exists. I wouldn't mind checking out the Undercity. Barrack Quarter. Yeah, why not? This looks like the Sun Temple to me. Well, I guess we'll go check out the Sun Temple then. Didn't properly... That's the barracks, okay. Didn't probably check out the Sun Temple, so this will be interesting. Don't know if we can get up there though. We're not wearing our garb.
Yes.
Hello. Minekeeper.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.
Oh, that could be bad. Let's just quickly say, just in case they get a bit angry at us and try and, you know, kill us. I sort of want to check out this little area here. This looks like hidden treasures or goodies or something, like a symbol or an ice claw. Probably not a chest, but it doesn't seem to be the case. It looks like it's evaporating before it can get anywhere. Hi.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
Oh, shh. Oh, gods. Nope! You... Gotta catch me first, copper! Oh, there's a magic symbol. I'll have to come back to that. No! I will not go down quietly. Kimmy. Think we can sneak past him? Fudge. Alright, fine. Ooh. Okay, let's not steal things.
You may pass, but treat this place with respect.
Ah, cool. So she doesn't care that I'm not wearing that fine garb. That's good. Suppose that'll be a bit too hard to say if he's wearing this all the time, let him through, and such. Anyway, let's grab that magic symbol. Bazinga. 7 out of 100 collected. Well, if it happens, it happens, huh? So, Sun Temple, what secrets do you have for me? Is this considered stealing? Nope. That goes down that way. Righto. I did not check this place out that thoroughly, did I? I just came and went like the whirlwind. Bless you! Walk blessed! Seems a bit... silly. I like it, but you're gonna get your feet wet. Like that guy, his feet are getting wet.
I'll keep walking.
Okay. Arcanist. Oh, this is quite the number of steps.
You do not belong here.
Blah, 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 blah. Well, you're worshipping a false god who I killed, so I'm pretty sure. Well, we're definitely not even because I killed your god, but you got the right to talk to me about not belonging anywhere.
Oh, hello. You're the companion of that mercenary, aren't you? Dalveric, or whatever his name is. I don't want to be disrespectful, but our time's so bad that the Order needs to resort to hiring mercenaries. I just don't know.
You're lucky I'm a pacifist. Not really, but I just don't see much reason to try and kill you for being a dick. Ooh, ooh, please, please. Oh. We can look at it this way. Oof. This is quite the view. Imagine falling down. I don't want to fall down, I just want to get up on the ledge so I can see a bit better. It seems they made it a bit hard to do that. But if I sit on the bench, I'm gonna look the other way, aren't I? Well, it's still a pretty amazing view. Be a really nice to watch the sunset up here, actually. Damn. Oh, wow. Enderal's beautiful. Sun Temple's very, very well laid out. Very nice place. So what do we have along the sides of the Sun Temple? The Emporium, or the Emporium, as one would probably
this
call it.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
Well, that keeper liked me. She said, "Well met." Oof, oof, oof. Baby. Good golly, this is amazing. You spurred into yawns. Crikey. You know what, I decided when I become King of Enderal, which I will do, this will be a nice place to live.
Well, if it isn't the prodigy. Say, is it true that you're an elementalist? One of the keepers told me. We should have a chat someday. Seems you could teach me a thing or two. Walk blessed.
Teach you? Okay.
Pathlessness. Wherever you look.
Yes, it makes sense.
Where is this supposed to lead?
Path turned 12, the star summer night. I think we've read that, haven't we? Maybe. Landscapes of Enderal, we've seen that.
That's beyond me.
Yeah, what's happening here? Is that Malphus? Hi. That could be Malphus over there. And they're just sort of like either dead or very, very stoned. Jesus, Emporium's big. Is this all one building? Oh, it is. Okay, so it's interconnected by these doors. Oh, it's Malphus. Huh.
Let's hope he knows what he's doing.
I thought that Malphus had a bow that I stole from him when I killed him. Didn't think he'd be depicted with a sword, but I suppose it's more symbolic than anything, isn't it? Looks like he's breaking chains, so whatever he's done something to help these people.
Work, work, work.
Holy crap, a keeper's sweeping the floor? What the fudge? You look different.
You just wait and see, fucking sissy.
Alright.
A foreigner, huh? What a surprise.
This is holy ground, Outlander. You do not belong here.
I'm just waiting for him to call me scum now. Scum! Outlander, what do you want? We're watching you. Scum! So many books to read and steal, huh? But no real time to do it.
Walk blessed. Oh, you're an Eterna, aren't you? Your ears, they look different.
Mm-hmm. Do I have anything I can disenchant? I'm pretty sure I got that piece of armor, actually.
Pathlessness, wherever you look, where is this supposed to lead?
Oh, farewell.
Shit. I have to remember that.
Ooh, increase your health by 10, or magic by 12. Yes, we've got two of those hanging around, so... And we can imbue these with fortify magicka by 1 point, because we don't know this thing too well, and we've got not very... Just 1 point? Yeah. Not worth it.
Work, work, work.
I think that enchanting's not going to be something I'm going to be able to do terribly well. Whoa. Oh, I wish I could steal these. That would look amazing in my home. I'm just saying. Sun Temple. Hello? Oh. Oh, whoa. What are you doing?
Keep walking.
Righto. I'll keep walking, you just
this
keep...
This is holy ground, Outlander. You don't belong here.
Secure chest, I don't need you. Oh, look at that, workbench. Steel curse, huh? What does it need? Steel eggnog. Hmm. Do I have a... I do. Bazinga. Whoops. That's the wrong way.
This is holy ground, Outlander.
Ah, yes, I've been here before. Let's see what it's got around. What is that on the wall?
Knows what he's doing.
Starling Gyro, hmm? Interesting.
Walk blessed.
Is there some kind of problem?
Oh, yes. Guess what? There is. Some people just don't get the meaning of the word reliability.
What are you talking about? Maybe I can help.
Huh. You're not from the Order, are you? Then I wonder what the blazes you're doing here. But fine. Who am I to reject a helping hand? Elia, the novice who was assigned to me. She's supposed to help me transcribe these Pyrian tomes the Grand Master is so obsessed about. But 2 days ago, she simply vanished. If I were to guess, I'd say she's strolling around enjoying herself somewhere in the nobles' quarter. I'd go look myself, but I'm lucky if I get to breathe within all this work. Go find her, and tell her to get her bloody ass up here and help me. If you do that, it won't be to your disadvantage.
Alright, I'm gonna find some missing people. Can't be that hard, right? Hi. You're a Nehrim's mage. But you don't want to talk to me. Constantine! Tell me more about the Order's history. Who are you exactly, and how did you come to be?
You really need me to answer that? Just take a look around. There are all sorts of great historical writings on us here. We're a bunch of bloodthirsty heretics who followed Tino Aranthiel's deluded son into the war against the gods, who gloriously defeated us in the Battle of Zaramar. Naratzel was locked into an old tower, and those of us who remained cowardly fled into the Nehrimese Mountains, and have since then terrorized and plotted against the poor people of the civilized world by all means necessary. Oh, and did I forget to mention that we eat babies for breakfast? Well, now I have.
Did I touch a nerve there?
Sorry. I suppose I just shouldn't have read that much Enderalean literature on the subject. If there's someone who deserves an award for biased misrepresentation of the facts, it's the buffoons who run this place.
Yeah, so you are, in fact, the Constantine Firespark from the mountain. Cool. How's it going? Which part of Nehrim are you from exactly?
Oh, that's hard to tell. Most of the time I was with Narathzul's order in the Kabeit Mountains. But when I was younger, I used to travel a lot, not only in Nehrim. What about you? Which idiots did you have the misfortune to be raised by? The foolhardy rebels up north? The bootlicking pawns of the Chancellor in the Middle Realm? Or the fanatic, mask-wearing, cultist oafs down south?
The latter. Ostian, to be precise.
Ostian, I see. A beautiful piece of earth, actually. But these sodding cultists and their creator have done their best to make it a living nightmare. Truth be told, it was them who made me join Narathzul's fight against religion back in the days. I was a young traveling arcanist then, and wanted to make some money in Ostian's arena. Fight some rabid animals, oh, you know the story. I had heard a lot about Nehrim South, and imagined a place at the pulse of life. Exotic music, adventure, beautiful women. But you know who greeted me when I reached the city gates?
Who?
Corpses. They burnt their skin off and then nailed them to crosses. There were at least 50 of them. Men, women, children. And they were set up at the roadside like trees in an alley. It was atrocious. The smell of burnt meat everywhere. The screams of those who still lived, and all of it only because some fool has decided that they had somehow acted against their god. I still dream of it sometimes. Well, that was when I declared war on religion. I was so sick of seeing people cutting each other's throats only because they project their own personal problems into some holy scripture or higher power. And that's not even the worst part. They're beyond reason. Why are you doing this, I ask them. Because my god told me to. What's left to say there? You can essentially justify anything with that logic. This is why this place makes me sick. We need the Order's manpower. They need our knowledge about the Piraeans, and we both do want the same thing, yes. But philosophy and freedom of thought are nowhere to be found. It's pathetic.
But is the problem really religion itself, not the people who misuse it for their own ambitions?
Yes and no. On the one hand, yes, a happy person will most likely never become a murderer, no matter if he or she follows the teachings of this creator or some Quiranian philosopher. But if something happens to this person, hunger, fear, shattered dreams, a peaceful ideology can make all the difference. What is religion after all? It's a guide to live life, a set of values. And even if it's just one line in the Holy Scripture that says, kill the infidels, how likely is it that a broken man will interpret it in a peaceful way? If you want a justification to spill blood, you will find it. If your religion was ambivalent to begin with, even better. There's a lot of discussion about that on Kira. And it drives me mad to hear people prattling on about how it's all a matter of interpreting the scripture in different ways. Blazes, if your ideology is so peaceful, why does it say, slayeth this, slayeth that, rather than just, get along? It's pathetic.
Pathlessness, wherever you look.
Yeah, I agree with you there, mate. Although the creator's literature was definitely a whole bunch of praise me or else I'll damn you to eternal damnation. That's pretty good. In other words, a truly peaceful religion shouldn't have ambivalent parts at all.
Yes, go on. Try to justify a massacre like the one in Ostian with a philosophy that consists of only two principles and nothing more. Respect those around you, and killing is bad regardless of the motives. Good luck.
So what we got here? But religion can do good. It gives people a sense of community, and without some sort of moral guide, people would just do what they want. That is complete bullcrap. I couldn't agree more. Religion is dangerous. I had to find out the hard way. Well, dangerous is yes and no. It depends, as he said, who is following the religious path and how a bit crazy they are. Couldn't agree more, mate.
Especially if people don't keep to themselves with it.
It's a very interesting conversation that it definitely ties to certain elements of this world, doesn't it? Who in this temple is part of your order? I'm having trouble telling you apart.
Oh, don't tell Lushi that. Altogether it's her, Yuslan, me, and two acolytes. Juslan is probably the most gifted entropist of the civilized world, and I doubt there's anyone who knows more about the Pyreans than Lushi.
Thanks. I'll see if I can talk to them now. Nope. You're just a keeper. And Magister Rhaegon, I've already chatted to you, but do you have anything else to say?
Walk blessed.
That's pretty good as well. That's not a door, is it? Nope. I have to wait till Magister Rhaegon goes away. Oh, this is where that explosion happened, huh? Okay. Don't really want to steal things from here just yet, even though I really need the money.
Wherever you look, where is this supposed to lead?
No, no, it's... They're pathless, they're screwed. Why is there a... Is that a... No, it's a wardrobe. It's still... What? That seems a bit fishy to me. And that one too. Maybe it's not fishy at all.
Let's hope he knows what he's doing.
I just don't know how that would open it up. The door, the bed's in the way. Oh, there's another level to this. Okay, we've found some interesting things. Huh. What are they called in Skyrim? Ents? No, not Ents. Spriggans, that's it. Secure chest. Ooh, a grand soul. Can't pass that opportunity up when you can steal things that might be valuable later on. Especially skulls. Very valuable. I don't have a problem at all. Whoever said I had a skull stealing problem is misinformed and wrong. One more section to go, it seems. Oh, the Sun Temple quarters, okay.
Who are you? Our ancient world seemed newborn in his eyes. No place could keep him. He yearned for the skies. He abandoned the way that Malthus foresaw. He followed.
Thou art my light, my glimmer at the horizon. Thy name is my sacrament.
As a wayward wanderer, despising the path
as in death
that was meant just for him. Yet the dreams that he sought in the deep red afterglow were as distant as ever before. He did find a home in the city below, where life neither purpose nor honor can hold. The woman who loved him held out her heart, and her suffering tore it apart. 'Cause he strayed in the void as a wayward wanderer, despising the path that was meant just for him. Yet the dreams that he sought in the deep red afterglow were as distant as ever before. Our ancient world seemed as old as his eyes. He had lived his whole life under empty skies. When a little boy asked him for the guiding path, he said, "Do not risk Malthus's wrath. 'Cause you'll stray in the void as a wayward wanderer, despising the path that is meant just for you. Yet the dreams that you seek in the deep red afterglow are as distant as they'll ever be."
Well done. That was amazing. May I wish for a specific song?
What would you like to hear?
Oh gosh. Whisperwood.
Sure.
Thanks.
Murmuring, whispering, creaking and crackling. Can you hear the voices of the wood in the wind? Can you see the light as it shines through the treetops?
There'll be more time to listen to those later. Like one, yes. Song's enough.
It will show you the
damn
way through the whisper wood. The whisper wood, where eternity's echo can be understood. Can you sense the depth of the
sacrament, and thy path I will honor in life as in death.
Dissolve and fade away with each step.
That was amazing. Holy crap, I'm so glad they translated that to English. Even though it was in German, it was still really good, but they chose a really good singer for that.
Met.
Well, it's getting dark. 8:12 p.m. Wouldn't mind exploring the Undercity.